To really unlock the power of Google Analytics, you're going to want to configure events. Events allow you to collect data across any type of interaction with your content. You might measure things like downloads, link clicks, when someone interacts with various steps in your purchase process, or fills out a lead form, or even watches a video. All of this information is collected and displayed in easy-to-understand reports. Here, I'm in the Events Overview report, and I got here by selecting Behavior, Events, and then Overview. Now, this data comes from the Google Merchandise Store, which is simply sample data that we can interact with. Now, it's important that I mention that events have to be set up programmatically. You'll configure code on your website in order to trigger events that will show up in Google Analytics. Now, events are composed of their category and their action. These are required to trigger an event. And here we see the event category, Enhanced E-commerce, as well as Contact Us. And if I select the event action, we can see the actions that were defined for these various events. In this case, add to cart, remove from cart, a product click, and so on. You also have the ability to assign labels, which are simply helpful to understand the context. In this case, Google has applied labels to each product. And then you have the ability to add a value. In this case, you may trigger the monetary value of this event action, or perhaps the value of, say, what percentage a user has completed a video view. And what's great is within these reports, we can extract a lot of data. If I select top events here on the left-hand side, I can see the top events by category, and we can select into that category to get a more specific view. And here I can see the event actions that took place. And if I bring in a second dimension, say event label, we can really begin to get a quick look at what's going on. Here I can see all the quick view clicks for each of these events. And I can see that removing from cart and adding to cart does not have any labels set, which may indicate to me that I have a problem with the way that I configured this. You can also view events by pages. Here I've selected the pages report, and we can see the total events that are taking place on each page. And this is helpful as we can understand where the majority of our actions are taking place. And of course, you always have the ability to bring in secondary dimensions to drill deeper and deeper into these insights. Events help you get a more granular view of what your user is doing, and they're incredibly important to every measurement campaign.